Come on, how many of you want to say, Lord, I love you? How many of you want to say, Lord, I love you? We always try to balance our worship with the hymns. Come on, say hallelujah. With the hymns. So I want us to go back and dig in, Pastor, into some old hymns without the hymnal. The coming king is at the door. You know that song? At the door, at the door, at the door, yes, even at
the door.
Come on. Look at your neighbor and say, at the door. Say, at the door.
At the door.
At the door. At the door. Yes, even at the door. Come on,
he's coming. He's coming.
He is even at the door. Put your hands together for the musicians. Drop it a little lower. Coming king is at the door, who once the cross was sinners bore, but now the righteous ones alone, he comes to gather home. At the door, come on, sir. At the door, at the door, at the door, yes, even at the door, he is coming, he is coming, he is even at the door. Now I saw this young man tonight for the first time. You didn't hear me? And since he came in here, I don't know how you feel, but he's worshiping God. You didn't hear me? And let me tell you a little secret. A woman came up to me yesterday, and she said, Wayne, I came all the way from Atlanta. She said, we drove all the way from Atlanta to get a piece of this worship. The next lady said, I came from Vermont. The next lady came up to me, she said, I came from Florida because I wanted to be a part of this. You're here tonight. You're not in Florida, but you are in the real thing. I say you are in the real thing. So let's sing like we're in the real thing. All right, everybody, at the door, let's go. Come on.
At the door. At the door.
Yes, sir.
At the door, yes, even at the door. He is coming. He is coming.
Yes,
he is here.
Let me hear you. Let me hear you at the door.
At the door.
That's it. Hallelujah.
He is coming. He is coming. He is even at the door.
How many of you know he's coming? How many of you know he is coming tonight? Lift up the trumpet and loud let it ring. Jesus is coming again. Lift up, that's it.
Lift up the trumpet and loud let it ring. Jesus is coming again.
Cheer up.
Cheer up, be pilgrim, be joyful and sing. Jesus is coming again.
Yes, sir, come on.
Coming again, coming again. Jesus is coming again.
Nations,
nations are angry by this, we do not.
Jesus,
Jesus is coming again.
Come on.
Knowledge increases, men run to and fro. Jesus is coming again.
Let me hear you, come on. coming again. Jesus is coming again.
Lift up the trumpet and loud let it ring. Jesus is coming again. Cheer up, ye pilgrims. Be joyful and sing. Jesus is coming again. Coming again, yes, coming again. Jesus is coming again. He's coming again, coming again. Jesus is coming again.
I said, Jesus is coming again. When I gave my heart to Jesus, these were the songs. The pastor came in from Barbados. His name was Newton King. I think he's in Florida. And I used to watch his movement. And I wanted to be like him. I wanted to be like, and I used to go to the crusade just for the song service. Because when he comes on, he had a smile. I say, praise team, he had a smile. Somebody said from Arizona, you all need to smile when you're singing. Jesus is coming again. And I love how he used to conduct. So he used to come on the stage with life. With energy. And his hands. Look at his hands. Lift up the trumpet and loud let it ring. Jesus is coming again. Cheer up the pilgrims. Be joyful and say. Jesus is coming. Again. Yes.
Hallelujah.
I wanted to be like him. Amen. The golden morning is fast approaching. Jesus soon will come to take his faithful and happy children to their promised home. Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning piercing through this night of gloom. Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning that will burst there too. There are those loved ones who have long been past. We'll all meet that day. The tears of those who are broken hearted
will be wiped away.
Come on.
Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning
piercing through this night of gloom. Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning that will burst there. Come on, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And then he will go and he will say, lo, Jesus comes. Lo, he comes. He comes all glorious. Jesus comes to reign victorious. Come on, lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Watch his chains. Come on.
Watch his chains with eyelids waiting.
Lord,
of heaven are shaking. Keep your lamps set ready for the Lord's return. Lord, he comes. Lord Jesus comes.
Hallelujah. Lord, he comes.
He comes all glorious.
Jesus comes
to reign.
sinners come, where Christ is pleading, no for you. He's interceding, looks on high, and crowns of glory haste to crown. Hey, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, Lord He comes, yes, Jesus comes. Come on, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, say hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you believe he's coming again, stand to your feet. Lo, he comes.
He comes, oh glory.
I said, Jesus comes. A verse, amen. Lo, he comes. He comes all glorious. Hey, you're sounding good tonight. There's nothing like the good old Advent hymns. Say hallelujah, people.
Hallelujah.
Amen. To God be the glory. Thank you. When we have professionals in the house,
amen,
we must use them in Jesus' name. Gifted musician. I don't want to be left out of the kingdom of God. Hey, this is the last Sunday night. Look at your neighbor and say, this is the last Sunday night under the tent. I don't want to be left out tonight. Come on.
I don't want to be left out. I don't want to be left out. I don't want to be let down out of the kingdom of God.
Hey.
I don't want to be let down.
Sing.
I don't want to be let down.
Oh,
I don't want to be let down
out of the kingdom of God. On the banks.
On the banks of the riverside, we gather to give God praise.
Oh Lord,
what privilege
your son Jesus
has given us.
So all the people gonna be there
up there in that quiet
place.
Oh yes, sitting
at Jesus' feet,
all because of his grace.
Sing,
I don't want to be left out.
Come on. On the banks of the river.
On the banks of the riverside, we gather to give God praise. Oh Lord, what a privilege.
Son Jesus.
Your son Jesus has given us.
So all the people can be there. Up there in that quiet place.
Oh yeah, we're sitting at Jesus' feet. All because of his grace.
Everybody lift your hands and say,
I don't want to be left down.
No,
I don't want to be left down.
I don't want to be
left down
out of the kingdom of
God.
For the last time, I don't want to be
left down.
Come on.
I don't
want to
be left down
kingdom of God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Please remain standing this evening as we pray. Father in heaven, we want to thank you. And we want to give you glory tonight that you've allowed us to come together once more and again in your presence to give glory, honor, praise, and magnify your great and mighty name. God, we pray tonight that even as the songs are sung, even as the music is played, and even as the word is preached, that somebody's heart, life, mind is changed, dear Jesus, that they meet you for whom to know is life eternal. We thank you, we bless you, and we honor you. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen, and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord this evening. We want to welcome you once more and again as we are meeting, amen, for our gospel explosion. Would you say amen with me? Amen. Glory to God. This is our last week together. This is our last week together. And it is bitter, but it is sweet because we know even today that God is in this place. What do you say? We want to welcome those of you who are watching us online as well. And we want to invite you to be digital disciples and virtual evangelists as we share these messages with our friends, our families, our loved ones, to invite them out so that they are indeed a part of this experience as well. May God truly bless you tonight as God's name is lifted up. Take care and please stay tuned for what God is going to do.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Richard Means, pastor of the Mount Sinai Church. Good evening, everybody. Are you having a good night so far? How was today? By the way, did you remember to pray for the campaign today? Did you remember? Speak the truth and shame the devil. All right, how about the evangelist? Did you remember to pray for the evangelist? Well, I tell you, I hope you did. I prayed for him. And guess what? As we were told not so long ago, this is the final lift, the final week. And guess what? We are going to pull out all the stops this week. Do you agree? I saw the evangelist when I walked in here, and it seemed to me that he is ready for another 4 weeks. Yes, he's alive and energetic. He was laughing. He was excited. So guess what? We want to pull together this week and make sure that all these seats are taken for the final lift. How about that? Do you think we could do that? We could do that if each person here tonight remember to take somebody with them on which night? Tuesday night. All right. So now, please, a couple of announcements I'd like for you to pay attention to. Firstly, every night this week is going to be victory night. By that I mean every night we are planning to have a baptism under here. Amen. And so that would be leading up to our final baptism on Sabbath. And this time it is going to be by the beach. We had a marvelous baptism this past Sabbath at the beach. And for those persons who were making their requests for the beach, you have got it. It is going to be this Sabbath after the preaching service right at the beach. Then, remember that we'll have our final anointing night this Wednesday. So those persons who want their personal extra virgin bottle of olive oil to be consecrated. Take it. Remember, don't open it. Take it here and it will be opened at the appropriate time. Many persons have been experiencing victory because of these anointing services. So this Wednesday night, remember now, it will be anointing service again. And finally, remember to see Pastor Garnet Morris. Pastor Garnet Morris is the pastor of the Lebanon Church. He has the vouchers for the free parking. So please do not leave until you see him. Otherwise, you're going to have to pay for your own parking. Good night, everybody. Let's enjoy the service tonight.
We have come to the time of the service where we give God thanks and praise, not just in words, but in deeds. We're going to invite you this time to prepare your hearts and to prepare the offering that God has blessed you with. We want to thank God. We want to thank God. Let's stand together. We want to thank God. We're going to sing and we're going to give the offering. We want to thank God for all of his blessings. God has blessed us so that we can be a blessing. What do you say? And that's a weak amen. I want to thank God for all of his blessings so that you and I can be a blessing this evening. The song says, you can't beat God's giving no matter how you try. I want to thank God for blessing us so that we can be a blessing, so that more of our brothers and sisters can come to know the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. Let us pray, and then we're going to lift this evening's offering. Father and God, we give you thanks and praise for all of your blessings. We thank you, Lord, for providing us with employment. We thank you for providing us with the monies that we need to take care of ourselves, our families, our friends. And right now, dear God, as we give back a little to your cause, we ask that you bless it, multiply it, we pray, in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen.
Oh, yes. There wouldn't be another Sunday night like this Sunday night in Queens. Every praise.
Every praise is to our God.
Every word of worship.
Every word of worship with one accord.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise is to our God.
Every praise. Let's all stand. Every praise. to our God. Every word of worship, wanna call.
Every praise,
come on.
Every praise is to our God.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah to our God.
Glory hallelujah.
Glory hallelujah. It's to our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise. Out of the kingdom of God. Hey. Oh, yes. Come on. Yes.
I don't want to be left out.
Come on.
I don't want to be left out.
Sing, I don't want to be left out.
Out of the kingdom of God.
I don't want. The ladies, he has on the banks.
On the banks of the riverside.
Someday.
Someday we will meet and say.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord, you know just how I long for that beautiful day.
So all the people gonna be there. Oh yeah, in that
quiet place.
Oh yeah, sitting at Jesus' feet. All because.
All because of his grace.
Somebody help us sing, come on.
I don't wanna be left out.
Sing, I don't wanna be left out.
I don't wanna be left out.
Hey.
Out of the kingdom of God.
On the bend of the riverside, we gather to give God praise, oh Lord. What privilege your son Jesus has given us. So all the people gonna
be there.
Out there in that
quiet place.
Oh yes, sitting at Jesus' feet. All because of his grace. Everybody say, come on.
I don't wanna be left out.
Hey, sing, sing. The kingdom of God. Everybody say, come on. I don't. Come on. Everybody sing. Come on. Out of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life you have been faithful.
Oh Lord.
All my life you have been so, so good. But every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness.
I will sing of the goodness of God.
Come on, let me hear you all my life. Goodness
of the goodness of God.
I will sing the goodness
of the goodness of God.
I will sing
of the goodness of God.
Come on, give the Lord a hand. Come on. Amen. Please be seated in his presence. I want to tell you, when this program comes to an end, you'll miss it. We want to welcome those online. We have many more online than we have under the tent. Thousands of people online listening all over the Caribbean. Share the link. Let somebody hear the message. This gospel of the kingdom shall be preached as a witness unto, come on, some nations, all nations, and then shall the end come. So I'm preaching the gospel tonight. I'm appealing for baptism tonight. I'm never afraid to do that. I love to do that. And I believe that the water is troubled. Somebody will say yes under the tent. Come on, somebody say amen. We want to thank you for your offering. And we are still short by 14,000. Please do not embarrass me amongst all these pastors. Okay? And so make sure that you bring the special offering so that we can defray the expenses out here. Thank you very much in advance. I notice my drum is not there. I'm seeing a fellow with a pot and a jacket. You from Jamaica too? Where you from? St. Kitts? Oh yeah, Kittitians can play good music. Oh yes, I had a crusade in St. Kitts. And you should go to Nevis. Yeah, they sent us there for I think our 50th. My wife's 50th birthday, something like that. Can't remember. Well, welcome, sir. And I hope you can fit in with the guys who are there. Amen? Come on, welcome him. Give him a hand, please. Yeah. So we have Michael. That's Michael, right? Who's Michael? Oh, Michael is on the bass. Ah. David is on the organ. Okay. All right, beautiful. All right, don't forget, we rest tomorrow night. Still have some time. But we come back on Tuesday night. On which night? Bring everybody here. I'll be dealing with jewelry. Straight from the word of the living God. When you see it, you'll be shocked. Okay, so we're going to be here on Tuesday night. I really enjoy Jamaica night, Trinidad night, but I must say I enjoy the Haitian night. They were so animated and so, you know, they were so happy that they were given a chance to come up. I really enjoy. Put your hands together for all Haitians, man. Sarafet! Don't forget, start getting your candles. All right, Saturday night is candle lighting night and also flag night. So we are not having flag night on Sabbath morning. We're having it Saturday night. Okay? And we'll be waving our flags to the singing of, I believe, one of the best praise team I ever had since I'm here. Come on, put your hands together for them. Man, the tent full, they sing. The tent empty, they sing. And we want to thank Wayne and his beautiful daughter. I wish I could come back and marry you. When I say marry you, I don't mean to me. I mean to somebody else. that's him? Hey, hi. Hi, come unto me, all you that labor and the heavy laden. Well, look at that. Are you talking about marriage at the right time? Huh? Yes, yes. I'm a marriage officer here and I have my marriage license. I can marry anybody. Anybody here in New York. I told you how I got it already. And we want to thank Robert and Cora. Come on, put your hands together and... Oh, Lord, what's the pastor name again? Nix? Hickson what? Dixon. That's what I know him as. Dixon. Put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them, please. Don't forget the gift exchange on Friday. Now, come on, don't be cheap now. And you know, did I have a partner? Who? You were my partner? Who? Oh, I said the guy in the organ. Okay. Well, boy, I ain't buying you no gift if you ain't buying me any, you know. You know, I'm joking. No, we're going to get, I'll get him a gift. $25 is the minimum on Saturday night. Okay? Not Saturday, Friday. And when you come, don't give anybody the gift. Hold your gift. We're going to make it a really celebratory night. And even if I go late on Friday night, is it last night? You must admit I respected your time. Come on, did I respect your time? You know, much sermons I had to cut just to finish on time? You know, I respected your time. Okay? Beautiful. Let me see what else I have here. Okay, we have the concert this Saturday from 5 to 7. Okay, Wayne? Bring some of the best singers from Brooklyn, from Queens, you know? And you want to hear me sing too? I will sing like my mother. Okay, we have soup Tuesday, Wednesday, and we have soup on the final Saturday night. I think that's all I have to say to you. Don't want to miss anything. Okay. Sabbath, the final baptism is on the beach. And I want to let you know I'll be going to the beach to baptize folks on Sabbath. I believe we're going to have our biggest baptism on Sabbath. Come on, give your hands, put your hands together for baptism. All right. I think that is it. So let me get ready to preach the word. That's over there. I thought it was here. All right. Let's get on into the message for tonight. And what's our topic for tonight, everybody? Come on, everybody. Come on, come on. We have people listening online. What's our message for tonight?
I used to be a caterpillar.
I used to be a what?
Caterpillar.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, having God as Father is not an automatic privilege. Did you hear me? And so even though we were created in the image of God, it does not say that we are children of God. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible gives a clear distinction between the children of light and the children of darkness. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 8, what it says here, reader?
For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord.
Yes, please.
Walk as children of light.
Walk as children of light. If you left the world and you come into the church, what was in the world you have to leave behind? You cannot come back into the church doing the same things you did in the world.
As the song says, it's a great change. Don't miss the adjective. Not just an ordinary change, but what kind of change?
Great change.
And so we are not born in the light, we are born in darkness. We are not born saved, we are born lost. We are born what?
Lost.
We are not born holy, we are born sinful. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, the gospel is clear. I want everybody to read this, please. What it says here?
We become children of God not by biological birth or genetics, but by faith in Jesus Christ.
Come on, somebody say amen. And so faith becomes the victory. Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 8. For by grace are ye saved through what?
Through faith.
Read on, please.
And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God.
Ah, praise God. Come on, somebody give God an amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, when a person accepts Christ, follow me here. A transfer, what is the word, Sister Morgie?
A transfer.
A transfer from the realm of sin and death to the realm of God's grace has taken place. Stay with me here, please. Now, when you buy a house, when you buy what?
A house.
I think I have it there. When you buy a house, a transfer takes place. The house, don't put that yet. The house is transferred from the owner to the buyer. Is anybody here? But the transaction can only take place, put it now, when the purchase price is paid. And so money is the payment for the transaction of ownership. Excuse me, please. Now, how do you apply this? Becoming a Christian involves a transfer. Follow me here tonight. You are not born a child of God. You must become a child of God. Yeah. And so even if you grew up in the church, even if you went to church with your parents, you are not a child of God until you accept God and keep all his commandments. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
But follow me here. But with this transfer, there's no need for you to pay the price. Because after you buy the house, you still have to pay the utilities. You still have to pay for heat. Am I speaking the truth? Yes, man. You still have to pay the utilities. But with this transfer from sin to salvation, the price is paid. And so before Jesus, in fact, let me say it here. And so because Jesus paid the price, when you accept him, the transfer is this. Put it on the screen. Come on, read it, Sister Margie. What it says?
You are no longer a child of wrath. You are a child of God, entitled to eternal life.
Come on, man. Don't miss that verse. That verb. Entitled
to eternal life.
To eternal life, man. You got a mansion up there waiting, man. A mansion of gold, man. Not of these bricks that you have here. Is anybody here? But before the house is transferred to you, put it. It is washed and clean and painted and polished. But then you must pay the mortgage. But with the transfer from sin to grace, from darkness to light, from error to truth, the price is paid by Jesus, put it. And it's a gift. Put it again. It's a what?
It's a gift.
You can't pay for it. If salvation were a thing that money could buy, the rich would
live
and the poor would
die.
You have to pay for it. It's free. And so Jamaicans can get it. Trinidadians can get it. I got to include them now. Haitians can get it. Dominicans, Vincentians, Barbadians. Is anybody here? God is not a God of a country. God is the God of the universe. He got the whole world. He got the whole wide world
in his hands.
He got the whole world
in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
He got Barbados, Jamaica
in his hands.
He got Haiti, Africa
in his hands.
He got Jamaica, Trinidad
in his hands.
He got the whole world. Come on, sing it. He got the whole world
in his
hands he's got the whole world. In his hands he's got the whole world. In his hands
he's got the whole world. Now let us look closely at a verse in the Bible spoken by Jesus. John 3:3. Come on, read it, Margie, what it says.
Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.
There's one thing I never threw aside when I left school, pastors, is the Greek and the Hebrew. I spent so much time in school with it. And so I'm looking at the word again. Put back the text, please. Put back the text. I'm looking at the word what?
Again.
Again in the Greek means from above. And so the transfer does not come from below. It comes from?
Above.
And so when I preach and you feel like trembling, you feel like crying, you want to come to the altar, you want to get baptized, it is not from below. It is from?
Above.
So watch me here. Is God speaking to you? And so watch it. Because the transfer does not come from below, but from above, ladies and gentlemen, it is an operation of the divine. So count it a privilege when God speaks to you.
Yes.
Count it a privilege when you get the impression to give your life to Christ and be baptized. Come on, somebody say amen. And if you think there is rejoicing down here, there is more rejoicing
in heaven.
Send me here tonight. And so the transfer is a metamorphosis. Metamorphosis means a change. Follow me here. You're going to like it. Now, just as science, just as what?
Science.
Can explain the metamorphic process of a caterpillar, which is in essence a transfer. Listen to me. Jesus, the best scientist, explains the transfer from sinfulness to holiness. Now, let us first look at the metamorphic process of a caterpillar. Put it. It is observed that when a caterpillar reaches maturity, he will spin in a cocoon. He will snug inside the cocoon. He will spin inside the cocoon. And after some time, an amazing thing happens. Instead of being a caterpillar, he now becomes a
butterfly.
Butterfly. He is totally changed. Watch this, watch this. Put it, put it, put it on the screen, girl. Put it, put it. He is totally
changed.
He was a caterpillar crawling. Now he's a butterfly. Means he can
fly.
As a caterpillar, anybody can kill him and mash him and kick him away. But when you come to hit him as a butterfly, he
flies away.
Wow. Now put it on the screen there, please. Put it. Put it again. Before he becomes a what?
Butterfly.
Read on, Sister Morgie.
He eats leaves.
Uh-huh.
But now that he is a butterfly, he eats leaves no more.
I'm trying to equate the thing with conversion now. What the second one? Come on, read it, Morgie. What it says here?
Before he was a caterpillar, he crawls on the ground. But now he is a butterfly, he flies.
And don't miss the last one. Instead, come on, read it, Margie. Instead of what?
Instead of munching on crunchy leaves, it flutters from flower to flower to drink sweet nectar.
Boy, that's beautiful, boy. I declare tonight, ladies and gentlemen, that every one of us walked in this caterpillar status. A life of sin and defeat. A life of cigarette and alcohol. Is anybody here? A life of adultery and fornication and homosexuality. That's the caterpillar status. A life of disco and lying and cheating. That's the caterpillar status. Can I tell you something? I used to be a caterpillar. I say, I used. In the bands of singing. Lady in red is dancing with me, chup de chup. I used to be a caterpillar, singing calypso, singing reggae. Why, yeah, Jamaicans, you all stop. What I'm trying to say is that sin makes you crawl. I say sin makes you what?
Crawl.
Sin makes you miserable, ladies and gentlemen. Sin is not good for you, and you can't do anything about it because sin is in you. But ladies and gentlemen, Jesus knows that. Oh God, somebody help me here, please. I said Jesus knows that sin is in you, and so he has become your savior.
Amen. Amen.
I used to gamble. I remember once I sat at a table gambling, three big men. We were playing deuce brack. You know what's deuce brack?
No.
You all grew up in the church. And a man came down and he said, $600 more. I said, $600, $200 more. Pull out his knife, bam. He said, boy, don't play with me. Put down the $200. He pulled out three aces, but I had three deuces. All is mine. If you see money, I winning. Then a lady came to gamble. And the first thing she did. She exposed all her mammary glands. That night I lost every cent. I see, I used to be a caterpillar. I used to be a caterpillar, but I'm not a caterpillar anymore. Come on, somebody say amen. Hey, I'll never be the same again. Oh, no. When sing, I'll amen. Never be the same again.
Oh, no.
Since my life has changed, I am not the same, and I'll never be the same again. But I read if it's one thing a caterpillar must do. Is a caterpillar must what, Moggy?
Must change.
Must change. A caterpillar must change. The caterpillar does not die until he changes. He dies when he changes. Come on, somebody talk to me now, man.
Come on.
And so watch it. Caterpillars start out as a destructive force. If they go on your flowers or on your water, they'll eat all. Am I speaking the truth here? But then a transformation takes place in their lives. You all listen to me, please. This transformation changes them from a destructive force into one that is beautiful to mankind. But put it even more amazing than that of a caterpillar. Is the change that Jesus brings about in the life of a human being.
Amen.
You see, this was in Tanzania. I don't know him. Speaks little English, but he speaks Swahili. And he is saying to me here, I won't preach like you. That's what all you know. I preach like you. And you notice I'm talking to him? And I'm saying to him, of course, God bless you. And after I baptize you here today, you'll be a preacher. I left Tanzania, and about 3-4 years after, I got this message. Hey, my name is Sam Mubadutu, whatever. I don't know who it is. You remember? You baptized me in the Indian Ocean when I'm at school studying to become a pastor. In fact, he came out of college, and he's now a pastor of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Hey, he was a caterpillar, but now he is a... And when you're a butterfly, your walk is different. You don't wear them short things. You don't wear them things everybody see in your mammary glands. Everybody seeing the nipples. Come up the thing, girl. Go by Macy's, get a good bra and cover them up. I don't know about your church, but you see, in my church, nobody comes up here and sing with arm out. Sometimes, Pastor, we are too loose. We are too what? Loose. If you know you're coming to sing, dress properly. Am I speaking the truth, amen. I'm not looking for friends in New York. I'm not looking for friends anywhere. The man who preaches the word of God must tell it like it is. You got to call sin by its name. Got too many mamby-pamby preachers around. They're just there to suit the people. I am not here to suit anybody, not even Dr. Jews. I am here to lift up Jesus. Oh, Lord, help me, please. Help me. So when you're a Christian, your walk is different. Your dress is modest. Your taste is holy. You can't go by the door and ask, sir. Shrimps. Or you can ask a pig. There are one person and one animal that has so many names. The devil, Lucifer, Satan, dragon, the devil, pig, swine, hog.
Oink, oink.
Oink, oink.
Arnold.
Arnold. Is anybody listening to me here, man? The great preacher from England, the founder of the Methodist Church, he was invited to dinner by the Queen of England. And when he looked at the table, he saw shrimp and pork and fish and chicken. And his prayer word, Lord, if thou can bless what thou hast cursed, then bless this meal. And watch this, huh? Watch this. Shh, shh, shh. Although the person continues to be fully man and fully woman, that person acquires the nature of God. This is powerful, you know. So watch it. Watch it. You are a sinner, but now you become a Christian. You acquire the nature of God. Everything I say, I have text to back it. Put it here. 2 Peter 1 and verse 4. What it says here, preacher?
Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature.
Yes, please.
Having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
Now, Sister Morgan alone read that. I want everybody to read it. Come on, everybody, after two. One, two. What it says? Thank you very much. Yeah, the iPad is just behaving badly tonight. Cutting out, cutting in. But I'll still preach it. Come on, somebody say amen. And so just as there were two natures in Jesus Christ, God and man, there are two natures in the believer. Born from above, born from below. So you have the sinful nature. I think I told you already. You have the sinful nature. But when you accept Christ, you have the higher nature. People are listening online. So can I do some theology? When you accept Christ, the lower nature doesn't go away. That's why people backslide. So when you accept Christ, you have the sinful, the lower nature, or the sinful nature, the higher nature, or the holy nature. I told you out here that the one that survives is the one you feed.
Correct.
That's why when you come to church, you have to keep your eyes off the bad people. You hear me? Keep your eyes on the good people. Don't listen to the bad, listen to the good. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand in the house of the living God. Man. And so as Jesus continues, he likens the Holy Spirit, the minister of regeneration, as a real presence that cannot be contained. In John chapter 3 and verse 8, here is what he says. Come on, read it, reader. What it says here?
The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth.
Yes, please.
So is everyone that is born of the Spirit.
And so watch it, watch it. Shh, shh, shh. Let me explain. The wind is not seen. Do you see the wind? We do not know where it comes from, nor by what laws it is governed by, but we see the changes it produces. I'm talking about the physical wind. Let's look now at the spiritual wind. Man just a while ago sinful becomes holy. Come on, you all answering me here, man. So watch it. A man walks in this tent, a sinner, but he gets baptized here tonight and he leaves here righteous. The thoughtless becomes serious. The prayerless becomes prayerful. And the rebellious and the obstinate becomes meek and mild and gentle. Is anybody listening to me here?
Transformation.
Transformation. Great change. And the good news is that the wind blows on everybody.
Yes, God.
Nobody can stop the wind from blowing. And the same wind that blows on me is the wind that blows on. There is nobody here who has never felt the wind. None. It's blowing. Blows every day. He's blowing tonight. He wants to come into your heart. He wants to let you know this is my world. This is my planet. I died on the cross to save you. Come on. I said the wind is blowing, man. It's blowing on my left and on my right. It's blowing in the middle. It's blowing on your heart and your heart and your heart and your heart. You just got to be honest tonight that when the appeal is made, you say, Pastor, yes, the wind did blow in my direction, and walk to this altar and get baptized. Come on, somebody say amen. Hey, Jesus is all the world to me. My life, my joy,
my all. He gives me strength
from a day to day. Without him, I would. Man, you all sing it now. Sing it. When I am sad to him. When I am sad, he makes me
glad.
He's
my friend.
Now let's talk about Nicodemus a little bit here. He does not understand how the transfer takes place. The Bible says in John chapter 3 and verse 9. Come on, read it, Sister Margie.
Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be?
Okay, well, what happened? How does this transfer take place? And Jesus had to answer. And Jesus answers in John chapter 3 and verse 14, what it says here.
And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
And so watch it. Jesus is taking him back to bring him forward. Nicodemus knew the story of the poisonous snake. So Jesus told him something that he knew about so he can help him to understand what he does not know about. Is anybody listening to me here?
Yes.
And so watch it. Let me tell you the story. God had enough with the grumbling of the Israelites. He sent plagues. He sent plagues in the form of hundreds of poisonous snakes. The snakes overran the camp, and the rebellious people were bitten. They came to Moses, Lord, please intercede on our behalf. And ladies and gentlemen, put it here. God in his what?
In mercy.
Come on, you gotta read it. God in his what?
In mercy.
Go ahead, please.
Forgave them and asked Moses to construct a pole with a bronze serpent on the top.
And the Bible says, put it here. Put it now, please. In Numbers 21 and verse 8, God says to them, read on, please. In fact, Moses says to them, what it says?
Everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live.
Ah, so watch it. Shh, shh, shh. With this illustration, Jesus was showing to Nicodemus the necessity of repentance. Being born again is not about human effort. It is not about position. It is not about prestige. You're not here with me here tonight.
Go on.
It is not about popularity. Is anybody here? It is not about piety. Being born again, put it, is about a relationship. That's why it says, if any man be where?
In Christ.
Come on, say the thing, man. If any man be where?
In Christ.
It's a metamorphosis. Once the butterfly emerges from the chrysalis, I read, its wings are wet and crumpled. It pumps blood into its wings to help them to dry and expand. And so once, put it here, once its wings are dry, the butterfly is ready to fly away and search for flowers to pollinate. Don't miss that. The butterfly doesn't just fly and go to flowers. It search for flowers to what, Sister Morgie?
To pollinate.
Pollinate. You have to apply that. We got to apply that. In the religious metamorphosis, Christ becomes our chrysalis. It is the butterfly's drive. In fact, if the butterfly's drive is to pollinate, then put it on the screen there. Read it, Sister Morgie, what it says here.
When we accept Christ, we become like those pollinators. We help set the seed of the word of God into people's lives. Yes.
And so coming to church and sit down is not pulling it with God. You cannot go to heaven without stars in your crown. Is anybody here? And sometimes the reason why some of us don't bring friends or folks to listen to the gospel is because of our lifestyle. You got to lead somebody to Jesus. You got to bring somebody to the foot of the cross. You got to hold their hands. Come on, somebody say amen. And you got to tell them, hey, lead me, Lord, I will follow. Sing the song, lead me, Lord, I will follow. Come on, you got to sing it nice, man. Stretch your hands like that and sing with me. Come on, stretch your hands.
Lead me, Lord, I will follow.
Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord,
I will follow.
You have called me.
You have called me. I will answer.
I hope you'll come tonight. When the call is made, even if you have to stand by yourself, even if it's one person, we'll baptize them tonight. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, tonight is a night of decision, man. Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that what? And I will do what? Come on, give the Lord a hand in the house of the living God. And so watch me, put it. If you are a caterpillar, there must be a change. And I believe we have some caterpillars here tonight.
Yes.
Maybe even some saying amen, they're caterpillars. I say, if you're a caterpillar, there must be a what?
Change.
The change entails the death of error and unbiblical truths. Oh, Pastor, I'm a Christian. I go to church on Sunday. Fine. God wants to lead you. My wife was a Christian going to church on Sunday, but now she keeps God's Sabbath. God wants to lead you step by step. Sunday keeping is not part of God's commandments. Jesus never changed it. It wasn't changed when he died or after he died. Come on, somebody say amen. The Ten Commandments represent the highest character of God. And why would God change his character? You just got to be obedient. Come on, somebody say amen. The change entails the end of immorality. The change entails moving from darkness into light. And so watch it. When you become a... Come on, say it. When you become a what?
Butterfly.
You must make a difference.
Yes.
a difference in your home, a difference on the job. I say you must make a difference. If you are a butterfly and you are not making a difference, then you are a caterpillar. You got to make a difference. On the train, wheresoever you are, got to make a difference. Can't go to church and put in the earring, and when you can't come to church and take out the earring, and when you're on the chain, you put it on. A Christian is a Christian even if he or she is in a room all by him or herself, because God is the one who's looking. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. And some of you think you can fool God. You got to make a difference. And so what's the difference? Here it is. Here it is, Margie. Therefore, if anyone be where?
In Christ.
Hold on. Let me take some time with this verse. If any man be in Christon. In, here is the preposition. Christ is the noun. If any man be in Christon, he is kenos krypton. He's a new creature. And don't miss the adjective. What?
New.
So to be new, you got to be in Christ. Not in the church, not in the pastor, but you got to be
in Christ.
So by chance they transfer the pastor, you will not leave the church, because you're not in pastor, you are in?
In Christ. Correct.
Let's read the text again. Therefore, if what?
Anyone is in Christ.
He is a what?
A new creation.
Read on, Pastor. Read on, Sister Margie.
All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new.
And things have become new. All things have become new, not for you, but for God. Because when you give your life to Christ, help me, Jesus. God takes your sins and he does what?
Cast them.
Come on, he what?
Cast them.
He cast them where?
Into the depths of the sea.
I heard a story.
No more.
I heard a story of this old man who sent his son off to med school. The son came back as a doctor, medical doctor. And when he came back, he had a party. You know? Raga, 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 raga. But that was not the father's thing, so the father went into the library. He went in where?
The library.
The library. And while he was there, he took the Bible down. And in the midst of the party, the father shouted, "Hallelujah!" The son came in, "Dad, this is the party. What is happening? You can't embarrass me." And the father said, "Sorry, son, but I was here reading the Bible. And I turned to Micah chapter 3 and verse 19, where it says that when God forgives my sins, he casts them into the depths of the sea. And I was so sinful, son, I had no choice but to shout, 'Hallelujah!'" And so he took away the Bible and he gave him a book, just threw a book in his lap. It was a geography book. And the father kept searching and he found a place in the book, a chapter on oceans, where they say in the chapter that there's a part of the sea where no man can dive to the bottom. And when he realized that nobody can bring back up his sin, he shouted again, "Hallelujah!" When God forgives you, God casts your sins where?
The depths of the sea.
And so the Bible says, 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 17. Go back. Let's go back and go forward. 2 Corinthians 5, 17. Everybody. 5, 17. Everybody. What it says? 2 Corinthians 5, 17. Second Corinthians 5, 17. Read it, Sister Morgie. If any man be in Christ.
If any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. Behold, all things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new.
And the Bible says now in the next verse, put the next verse, please.
And all things are of God.
Yes, please.
Who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ and hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
Come on, somebody amen. Say amen. And so God wants to reach you tonight. Will you allow him? If you want God to reach you, wave. Come on, man. Come on, man. If you want God to bless you, wave your next hand. If you want God to transform you, stand to your feet and say, hallelujah, thine the glory. If you want God to come into your life and change you completely, then sing with me, hallelujah, thine the glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. Bow your heads, please. Let's pray and make this appeal. It's about 8:45, 8:50. Bow your heads. Say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you. Thank you for the message. The preacher is going to make an appeal tonight. Come on, everybody. The preacher is going to make an appeal tonight. And if the appeal is for me, help me to go forward. Help me to go forward. Lord, I'm a member of the church. And I want to help somebody to come forward. So put somebody in my way. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. And so who would bring the first person tonight? Which member in this church will hold somebody's hand and bring them to the front? Which member? I think I see some movements behind there, Pastor. Oh, yeah, I see some movements behind there. Come on, yes, yes, I see a hand waving. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand in the house of the living God. Come on, that's how you all clap, man. Which member here tonight will hold somebody's hand and bring them down to the front? Which Bible worker here tonight? God bless you. I see somebody's coming. Hey, somebody's coming. Put your hands together for her, please. Come on, give her a hand in the house of the living God. Anybody else? Anybody else? It's not late. I see somebody else coming here. Come on, somebody say amen, man. Come on, hold somebody's hand. Hold somebody's hand and bring them to the foot of the cross. God bless you as you come. Hold somebody's hand. Hold somebody's hand tonight. God bless you. Somebody else move in here, please. I think I see a movement here. Did I see movement? No, I thought so. God bless you as you come. Tonight is your night for baptism. Don't put it off. I heard a clap. That means somebody else is coming, man. It's the last week. It's the last Sunday night. There will not be another Sunday night. Take the opportunity now. Today, if you shall hear his voice, harden not your. Come on down. God bless you as you come tonight. If you'll just come tonight, God will bless you. God will bless your home and your children. God will bless you with good health and long life. Is there somebody else? Hold somebody's hand tonight. Hold somebody's hand tonight. It's the people's night. Ah, do we have any butterflies here? Reach out to somebody. Hold on to the caterpillars tonight. Sing a song, Wayne. Sing a song. It's not even 9 o'clock yet. Sing a song.
I've wandered far away from God.
But now
I'm coming home.
Oh.
Hey, somebody's coming. Somebody's coming.
The paths of sin.
God bless you as you come.
Too long.
Hey, bring your children tonight. God bless you as you come. God, I'm coming home.
Lord, I'm coming home.
Sing it. Sing it. Sing it.
Coming home.
I'm coming home tonight.
Coming home.
Never more to roam.
Never more to roam.
Open wide thine arms of love.
Open wide thine arms of love.
We have 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Can I have 7 pastors? 7 pastors, please come. 7 pastors. Pastor, you're going to talk to them. Get their decision and lead them to the back to change. Come, pastors, please. I need 7. I only have 2. Come, pastors, come, please. Come fast, please. Pastors, come.
With bitter tears, Lord, I'm coming home.
It's the last Sunday night, your last chance. Coming home.
Coming home.
Pastor Kade, look one right here, please.
Coming
right to the end. When you are finished, pastors, lead them to the back.
Open wide
thine arms of love.
Thine arms of love.
Lord Jesus, Lord.
Lord, I'm coming home.
I've wasted
many precious years, but tonight, Jesus, I'm coming home.
Hey, bear with us, bear with us. Sing it away and sing it.
I know weeping.
You can fill it up in the back, darling. Take
with
up.
Bitter,
you should be filling it for her.
Tears.
Now, right now.
But now, I'm coming.
Come on, sing it for the last. Coming.
Coming home. Coming home. Never more to go.
Just before I ask you to sit, all a while for me, musicians. Thank you. Playing very nice. Thank you very much. But hear me. I'm talking to the members of the church now. You want to renew your covenant with God. You want to start over again. I want you to indicate by coming to the altar, please. Grew up in the church from Jamaica, from Haiti, from wherever. But you want to renew your covenant with God. Can you identify yourself by coming to the altar, please? If there is one, there'll be many more. So yes, you just come. You just come. God bless you as you come. In New York, nobody studies nobody's business. But you know your business. Can you come and join? Who'd be next? Come on, man, don't prolong the meeting. Just step out in faith. You know. You're backslidden in your heart. Won't you come? Use the pandemic as an excuse for being unfaithful to God. Who will join her? God bless you as you come. You think I'm begging you, not begging you? I'm appealing to you. I'm counting to three and I'm finished. Who will come at one? Who will come at two? Is somebody coming at two? And who will come at three? We give God thanks to you for your braveness there. I pray that God would bless you. Come on, say amen, somebody. Come on, say amen, man. I pray that God would bless you. Yeah, buddy, you need help. Even if you come for baptism, we're not baptizing you tonight. I don't know. You look like you're high. Need help. I don't know who here can help you, but you need help. But God, yes, God is willing to help you. Come on, somebody say amen. Thank you very much. You may have your seats as we prepare for the baptism tonight. Yes, take it off, please.
Lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said, he will not thy foot to be moved. The Lord is thee. He will not slumber or sleep. For the Lord is the keeper. The Lord is upon.
Pastor Stevenson or Pastor Harris, please come. You don't leave the pulpit empty.
Foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is my shade upon the smite thee.
the church say,
strange occurred. The renowned evangelist came to the island to preach, and as he stood, he very quickly ran through the topic that he had for the night. And then a strange look came over his face, and people who were watching were trying to figure out what was going on, because anyone who understood this person's reputation knew he was usually a little smoother than this. And then all of a sudden, something came over him, and he began to preach as he had never preached before. He preached about life in Christ. He preached about the certainty of judgment. He preached that now was the time to give your life to the Master. And as he opened the doors, people began streaming forward. A strange power was moving, and folk wondered, what in the world is going on? Some just chalked it up to a strange night, a moving of the Lord. Folk came that night and gave their lives to Christ. Early the next day, Jamaica was struck with one of the most powerful earthquakes that has ever hit any place in the world. And hundreds, yea, thousands died the next day who the night before had been there hearing the preaching of the gospel. And many responded, not understanding and not knowing that for many, that would be their last night. Now, all this week, we announced that opportunity would be given for men and women to surrender to the plan of God through baptism. And last week, there was not one night that we passed this meeting without somebody saying yes and going in that water. And I said, Father, you did it last week. This is our last week. Lord, you cannot let us come up empty. You cannot let us come up dry. And as I stand here right now, I'm being told that for this evening, we have no one ready to get baptized. Now, I could just say, oh, well, I could just go take my waders off. I could just get dressed. I could just go home and call it a night. But somehow, the real possibility exists that God is speaking to the heart of somebody. And so far, you've managed to stay in your seat. So far, you've managed to put it off. So far, you've managed to convince yourself that God wasn't talking to you. He was talking to the person next to you. But here's my problem. There's a reason that the Bible says, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. There's a reason the Bible says, now is the day of salvation. Because what I don't understand and what you don't understand is that when God opens the way, it is in that moment that you've got to move, because you're not moving on your own strength. You are moving on strength provided by heaven for that moment. And when you dismiss the invitation of God, when you put off conviction, what you are doing is saying to God, God, I own this moment, and I will move when I'm ready. But you don't move when you're ready. You move when God is ready. And so tonight, it's not just Sunday night. Tonight, it's not just the day before we report back to the rat race and everybody gets back into the commute on the highway. No. Tonight is the night that somebody needs to say, Father, I hear you talking to me. Father, I will surrender. Father, I will quit fighting, and I will own your invitation. And before we leave here, before we cover this pool back, and before we just accept the fact that nobody wants us to surrender to Christ tonight, I've got to ask yet again, who is under conviction? Conviction doesn't show on the face, but it shows in the heart. And if God is speaking to you, if God is pulling on you, if God is tugging you, I'm saying it's time to move. Father in heaven, we could easily shut this down and go home. But what if that one person who you brought here tonight to be baptized is sitting on the edge of their seat waiting for somebody to ask one more time, and we don't do it? What if they leave here without moving on your power or your promise? What if they leave here and ignore the invitation of heaven? None of us own time. None of us own tomorrow. None of us understands that if we leave here tonight, we don't know what tomorrow holds. And so, maker of heaven and earth, Lord of glory, I'm asking, yea, begging and pleading, that what you did for us last week, you would do for us tonight. That you would compel somebody to accept your offer of mercy tonight, recognizing there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. If they need courage, give it to them. If they need strength, give it to them. If they need a nudge, give it to them. But in Jesus' name, let your perfect will be accomplished tonight. Amen. And so here we have it. Here we have it. If you were the one that God wouldn't let us leave here without your soul salvation being attended to, just put your hand up. I will come and walk with you. Where are you? Just put your hand up. I'll come and I'll walk with you. Somebody's name is in the church book, but not in the book of heaven. Where are you? I'll come walk with you. Somebody's been playing church, and now it's time to stop playing. Put your hand up. I'll come walk with you. To everybody looking on, they just feel that you're the best thing walking since Jesus Christ. But you know the condition of your life right now. And you recognize that God has been telling you it's time to straighten up and fly right. I'm a preacher, not a private investigator, so I don't need to know your business. I just need to know that tonight you put up your hand and said, I want to make it right with the Lord tonight. Getting ready to pray and go home. But where are you? Where are you? Just put your hand up. I'll come walk with you. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Somebody said if he asks one more time, I'll do it. Well, here's your one more time. Let's go. In Jesus' name, let's go. Let's go. Pray, church. Pray. Pray. When this day goes into the books of heaven, it will either be marked down as the day of victory for somebody, or perhaps marked down as someone's last chance to do the right thing. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Come on, my friend. Let's go. Put your hand up. I'll come walk with you. I'll come walk with you. The Bible said that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached for a witness. And what that simply means is some will say yes, some will say no, but everyone will have had an opportunity. Is tonight the night that it cannot be said in heaven that this person wasn't given an opportunity? Is that you? Is that you? Father in heaven, I have no clue how precious a soul is, but you do, because you died to save us. And tonight is an opportunity for somebody to stop playing and to say all to Jesus, I surrender. Somebody needs to make it right. Somebody needs to get their heart together with you. We've called and we've called and we've called again. Before we close this service and go home, I'm asking you one more time, Father, who do you have for us tonight? Who do you have for us tonight? Who do you have for us tonight? Who do you have? Pastor Dixon, come. What happened? I want you to talk to the pastor. Pastor Cadet, I want you to pray with this young man. We have a young lady who made a decision tonight. She's going back to get changed. Is there somebody else? I've been a preacher most of my life, but I ain't been living right all of my life. And I'm at a point now where I've made up my mind, I do not want to be left out. To somebody else that needs to say goodbye to foolishness and goodbye to whatever was holding you back. Anybody else? As we're waiting for our dear sister to come out, is there anybody else? I extracted from God a promise that this pool would not go unused one night this week. And I thank him for answered prayer. But here's the thing. If there's somebody else sitting here ducking conviction, God tried to grab you and you swing this way, and God tried to grab you and you swing that way. Understand that if you escape heaven, you've done yourself no favor. Lord, we thank you for the sister that came forward. And all I can do is beg and plead that in these closing hours of Earth's history, that you would help us to understand that time is shorter than it's ever been. Help us to make our calling and election sure. And help us to get right so that we don't have to get left. As our dear sister changes, we ask your blessing on this pool of water. We ask that tonight it would be the gateway to heaven. And we ask that as she comes up out of the watery graves of baptism, that her life would be transformed and that your sweet Holy Spirit would be in charge of her operation. We thank you for hearing and answering prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise team. Lead us in one more song, if you don't mind. I'm going to get in the water.
Jesus said, here I stand. Won't you please let me in? And you said, I will tomorrow, yeah. Jesus said,
it's all.
I am he who supplies all your need. And you said, I know, but tomorrow, ooh, yeah, tomorrow. Please take my hands, and you said I will tomorrow, yeah. Jesus said, I am he who supplies all your need, and you said, I know. But tomorrow, oh, tomorrow, I'll give my life tomorrow. I thought about today. Oh, so much easier to say. Tomorrow.
man who said, tomorrow would ever come for you. Still you laugh and play and continue on to say.
Destin, Destin, let me just have your attention, please. I know it's late, so let's just settle down, please. We're going to do the vows at this time. We're just asking you for reverence in God's house. My sister, we want you to answer in the affirmative. That means yes to these questions. Do you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord? Do you accept the teachings of the Bible as expressed in the statement and the fundamental belief of the Seventh-day Adventist Church? And do you pledge by God's grace to live in harmony with these teachings? Do you desire to be baptized as a public expression of your belief in Jesus Christ to be accepted into the fellowship of the Seventh-day Adventist Church and to support the church in every way possible? You've heard the question posed to the candidate, and she has answered in the affirmative. Is there a motion that we baptize her, but before baptism, we accept her as a member of the church? It's been moved. Is there a second? Moved and properly seconded. All those who are in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed by the same sign? It's carried. I'm wondering if we could sing this song, All the Way My Savior Leads Me, as she goes into the pool. And I'm going to, that's her husband right there. Why don't you just stand up to support your wife first? Yes. All the way.
All the way, my Savior needs me. What have I to ask beside? Can I die? Who true life
has been my guide?
Has been my guide. Every peace
divine
is comfort. Here by faith
in him
to dwell.
For I know, what here
before me,
Jesus
doeth all things well.
And we are going to pray for the water. And so, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we just ask you to give a double portion of blessing to the water, so that as this your child is submerged, she will plunge in the blood of Jesus Christ. And as she comes up, may she come up by faith, through grace. And so, because my sister, you have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior from sin, we now baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
would you be free from your burden of sin? There is power in the blood.
Come on.
Power in the blood. Would you give his praises to sin? There is wonderful power in the blood.
Come on.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood.
All right. Before you leave, we have one announcement. But let me just pronounce another blessing on you. Bless them, Father, as they go. Give them special protection. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Okay, you will notice I have in my hand here something very nice and special, courtesy of the Gospel Explosion campaign. If you go over where you usually take your soup, you can collect a bun. Spice bun is a real delicious spice bun. It's for you. Collect yours and see you on Tuesday evening.
Power, wonder-working power in the blood.